Okay, the next thing we need to talk about is phase transitions. Phase transitions is pretty much what it describes there in the words. You're going from one phase of a substance to another phase, and that requires either a release of heat or an absorption of heat in order for that to happen. The best example of what we commonly know is freezing. Taking H2O liquid and into H2O solid. This is not a chemical reaction per se, it is a physical change, but we write it as a chemical reaction in this process here. We also know that in order for this to happen, heat has to be released, so this is an exothermic reaction. So we have -6 kilojoules per mole of heat given off. And we use FR as the subscript for delta H because we have a lot of delta H's or change in enthalpy for these reactions. So that's we're going to be using that from here on in as well, these little subscripts. For this one right here, going from solid to liquid, we know that is melting, but the scientific term for melting is fusion, so we're going to use the fusion part of that. And so this is delta H, or the change of enthalpy in terms of fusion, will be the exact same number only in the opposite direction, so that'd be a +6 kilojoules per mole. The example that we have for that is we want to know how much heat is required to melt 25 grams of ice, or how much heat is actually going to be given off here, but you can also say how much heat is needed. So we start with 25 grams, and we need to know how many moles, because our delta H is in terms of kilojoules per mole. So we have to change the grams of water or ice into moles. And as we know, a bajillion times that 18 grams, which is 16 grams of oxygen, 2 grams of further 2 hydrogen, because it's 18.0 grams for water. The grams cancel out, and then -6.00 kilojoules per mole. Kilojoules per mole will give us the moles cancel out, and that tells us that 8.33 kilojoules of heat is going to be released in this process. Now, two other phase changes that we look at are vaporization and condensation. In vaporization, then, this is going to be changing liquid to gas. This is not evaporation, that's not the correct scientific term we use. It's a vaporization process. And we know that the heat has to be absorbed in order for that to happen, so that's 40.7 kilojoules a mole. The opposite of that is condensation, so this would be negative, this would be exothermic. The same value, different sign, 40.7 kilojoules per mole. And the example for this, how much heat is released with condensing 30 kilograms of steam. So we have to change the kilograms to grams. Why? Because we know we're going to have to change the grams to moles. So we got to get grams first, kilograms cancel out. Then we change the grams to moles, so the grams cancel out. So the grams go on the bottom, and the moles cancel out with the kilojoules per mole. And we get -6.78 × 10⁵, or just under a million kilojoules. All right, so the last two phase changes that we need to discuss is going from solid to gas and gas to solid. And carbon dioxide is most famous for this because carbon dioxide solid is dry ice. And if you've ever seen dry ice, you see that the steam comes off it. You don't see liquid as it warms up. And that's because it doesn't hit liquid. The phase diagram you're going to look at is going to show why that works. But it goes directly from solid to gas. That is called sublimation. So the delta H value for this sublimation reaction is a positive value. And then the opposite, of course, going from gas to solid, that's called deposition. I have no idea why it's called either one. I'm sure there's some history. I should sit down and find out, but right now, I do not. So, the heat of deposition then has to be exactly opposite, same value, whatever that is, but it's going to be negative instead of positive. So, your practice problems are at the end of the Google Docs, and have fun.